section, we are seeing a lot of movement in the market as the US session is going to be happening. One, we have the election voting count, and now that is going to impact all the segments of the market. As of now, Mr. Biden is leading, but the lead is pretty narrow, and because of that, the increased volatility is likely to prevail. And it is not likely that we will have the confirmed results anytime soon. It might even take a couple of days till we have the final count. So it's going to be a long drawn process, and we will have to live with that. The increased volatility is here to stay, at least for next couple of days. On the data docket, we got the services PMI numbers for the China, and here there is a robust recovery, and for the month of October, the services PMI rose to 56.8, and this is the second best reading for this decade. So you can see from the magnitude that this is phenomenal, and this is coming in backdrop of the consecutive rise for the PMI readings for last couple of months since the recovery began after the initial shock of the coronavirus pandemic in China. For the European session, we have the final PMI releases coming in for Germany, France, but we will not really go into the details of that. We are not really expecting any big revision, and if something happens, as I said, today is the election day, so these are likely to be shadowed by other fundamental developments taking place in the market. Later in the day, we are also scheduled to get the ISM non-manufacturing number, and here for the month of October, the ISM non-manufacturing PMI is likely to be around 57.5, which will be just slightly lower than the prior reading at 57.8, but I think given the fact that this has been a phenomenal recovery, so slight deviation from the prior reading is not really going to be a concern, and it is going to underscore the resilience of the US economy. But of course, we have the cases of coronavirus, the COVID pandemic rising again, and that is going to impact the economic outlook for coming months. So we have to be watchful on that count as well. Now let's shift our attention to the technical aspects, how the current shifts in the market are impacting our technical outlook, and we will see the possible impact and how we can gear up for the volatility. Let's start with the Nasdaq's technical outlook first. This is the daily time frame chart, and here the Nasdaq has made a low around 11,000, and now it has started to rise. And as you can see from this bar, we have this increased volatility, and the width or you can say the spread is a lot higher, around 4 to 5 percentage points for the day. Of course, we have seen some correction from the higher side, but after looking at this consolidation, the base on the lower side, just above the 11,000 levels, I feel the equity segment has turned the corner, and most of the equity indices are poised for the gains. And all the three key equity indices for the United States are in the positive territory today, and this effect is also being visible in the other major economies and their equity indices, European equity indices in particular. So taking that into account, I think for next couple of days the bias is likely to remain on the bullish side, and the reason is that now that the US election will be done, and we will have the winner in next couple of days, so most of the attention then again will shift back to the economy and how the things are going to be managed on that front. And that is also good for the equity segment participants, and as is the case, the fiscal stimulus is likely to be passed, and that is going to be a major bone of contention. So that is going to drive the next leg of rally and how these negotiations unfold for the increased fiscal stimulus. So looking at the lower time frame chart, I think we have to be watchful around the area closer to the central pivot point of this month's pivot point series. Of course, if you look at the regression curve, it is still sharply bent on the lower side, but the upward momentum has been equally sharp and these gains have been phenomenal to say the least. And if we see that the Nasdaq is able to hold on to these gains and consolidate closer to this central pivot point, then that is going to change the outlook for bullish side in the Nasdaq, and in due course of time, as the price action is above even the upper band of this regression curve, you will see the flattening of this curve. And as I said, this is likely to provide support in the near term if we see the consolidation for Nasdaq happening just above this central pivot point. Then we can utilize this area as the marker while deciding to go for the fresh entries around this price zone. So if you want to pinpoint the entry and exit points, I think along with the central pivot point of this month's pivot point series, we also have to keep in mind the formations on the SMA front. And on the lower side, given the fact that this turnaround has been pretty sharp, we have this 50 and 100 SMA just below this prior swing low. And given the fact that Nasdaq has rallied substantially from those levels, we will have to be a bit patient here and allow the SMAs to catch up with the price action. And I think this consolidation phase low is going to be our possible stop loss level. I think any stop loss just little below this prior swing low is going to be helpful while looking for the entry anywhere closer to this 200 SMA. And as I said, in due course of time, we can expect these SMAs to catch up with this 200 SMA as the price action has now shifted above it, and that is going to provide the impetus for these SMAs to move higher. And we can indeed look for the buy entry anywhere around 11,400 levels. I'm not precise here. We will have to look at that price band and see how the consolidation unfolds. And whenever we see that the base has been formed, we will be in good position to go for the fresh entry around that price zone while keeping the stop loss anywhere below this immediate swing low. And I think that is also going to give us the excellent risk reward ratio on the higher side. We will be able to target the price around this immediate swing high, which is there around 11,800, and anything above that should also be possible looking at the change in momentum for the equities in the broader market. Gold is also going to benefit from the possibility of increased stimulus, and because of the easy monetary policy, the gold has gained substantially, but its days are still you can say bright, and we can expect it to shine in coming days also. So looking at that possibility, I think technically it has consolidated well after this substantial rally, the phenomenal rally, and for last couple of months it has found good support on the lower side anywhere close to 1850, and it had found the buyer. Even this time around it had rebounded just little above the prior swing low, and as the things stand, as I said, the one of the driving factor is also going to be the stimulus for the US economy and the easy monetary policy, and both these things are quite favorable for the gold, and as a result of that we can expect the gold to continue its bullish trajectory. The earlier trajectory for last couple of months it has been in the sideways, but if we get the break above this prior swing highs, then that will open up the door for the gold to rally towards its prior swing high, the US dollar 2000 per ounce levels or even beyond that. So looking at that possibility, I think we should be trying to find out the possible entry and exit points which are going to provide the excellent risk reward ratio for us. So here on the lower time frame chart, we have to rely on this central pivot point of this month's pivot point series around US dollar 1890. Here we have this good support coming into play, and as we have seen in today's session, even after the increased volatility, the gold has indeed found buyers and it has been able to hold onto the support zone and hold above it. So that's also a positive sign if you want to go for the buy trades in the gold. Of course, the regression curve is still bent on the lower side, as we had break below this consolidation phase, and that had tilted the scales against gold's rise. But now this sharp recovery is again giving us some reasons to believe that the support is still intact, closer to the prior swing low, and as a result of that, we will be in good position if we are able to figure out the optimum entry and exit points with risk reward ratio which will be better than at least 1:2. So to figure out that entry point, I think we will have to rely on these SMA crossover structure. We have the 50 SMA crossing above the 200 SMA, so we have the golden cross in place for the buy side trade. And on the lower side, we have these prior swing low and prior swing high areas, which are also likely to provide the support for the gold on the lower side. Along with that, we also have the 100 SMA around 1890 USD per ounce. So taken together, we have these multiple factors which are going to provide the buying momentum for the gold if in case the golds drop even further, like 10-15 USD per ounce. And I think we can be keeping the stop loss anywhere around US$1,870, and that should serve our purpose well. And many fundamental factors are also pointing to the continuation of the upward trajectory in the gold, and also the increased volatility surrounding the US presidential elections are also likely to help the gold's case. So taken together, along with this technical outlook, I think most of the factors are pointing to the upward journey for the gold, and the risk reward ratio also seems good enough if we are going to go for the entry anywhere in the price band of US$1,890 to US$1,900. So we will have to wait for some time and allow the consolidation to take place, and then maybe in the latter hours of today's trading session, we can indeed think about going in for the fresh entry while targeting the levels even above these prior swing high. So for the risk of around 20 USD per ounce, we will be in a position to target around 40 to 50 USD per ounce, that is the price target, or closer to US$1,950. So that is going to provide us the risk reward ratio of better than 1:2. So that's it from my side for today's session. If any of you have any query or any idea to share, you can write it in the comment section, and I would be more than happy to take the discussion forward. Before I sign off, I would also like to remind of the risk associated with trading in the financial instrument, and one should be careful while using the information provided. Have a fabulous day ahead. Goodbye.